I just really love physics. And I like Minecraft, but the physics here are not that realistic. Furthermore, Minecraft's world is infinite, just like your mom, which isn't that realistic. So my goal is to make a Minecraft clone where you can walk around on a cube planet with gravity and stuff, because that's realistic. Okay, first add a cube to the scene and then let's add some gravity, which is actually pretty easy and just takes the knowledge of high school physics. Which I don't have, so Google is my friend. Okay, so we have a nice sphere smashing into a nice cube. Nice. But kinda boring. You know what's better than one cube? 1000 cubes. Now, smashing is nearly as satisfying as in real life. But it's still kinda boring that way, because obviously you need at least two parties to participate. Looking at cubes colliding with each other is just a lot of fun. But even though attraction is normally one-sided for me, it's generally not for most other beings. Well, luckily, Brackies, the master of attraction, has done a tutorial about just that. Beep. Honestly, watching this video, you might think that I did all of this in half a day, but I love watching these little cubes flying around, and I'm always rooting for the little ones in the background in hopes that maybe one day they might have a teeny tiny chance of inviting the inevitable future of becoming one big blob. After simulating the creation of a universe, I should actually start including some features for Minecraft, because the video title is not "Having fun with Unity's physics system while using Minecraft textures with some jokes to pass the time." I mean, it would be less clickbaity, but YouTube limits the title length, so that's my excuse. Okay, Minecraft is actually one of the few games that has this rare feature called First Person Controller, basically meaning you can walk around and stuff, just like if it was actually you in the game. Seems simple to implement, right? Well, it's me we're talking about here. So it took me a few days, because the fucking rotation from Unity is shit, and I hate it, and I never want to rot in anything anymore in my life. There are countless tutorials out there that do character controls, even with artificial gravity and so on. But somehow they all conveniently leave out the code from the other part. So I did what every sane person would do and hoped that there would be some magic solution somewhere deep hidden on the internet. Sebastian Leek released his code for a sphere and a character controller. It's not working perfectly, but honestly, at this point, I just want to finish this project. Yeah, a sphere is more or less nice and easy, but how do you translate that rotation correctly to a cube? I have no clue. I just added the box to each side that tells the script in which direction to look. And it works most of the time. Applying some slurping, it even transitions kinda smoothly. Okay, I think it's time to implement the next super unique feature of Minecraft: picking up blocks. But we are making a totally accurate physics-based game here, and currently, humans can't just grab up a cubic meter of dirt, put it in their pants, and call it a day. Meaning that if you want to pick up an object, you have to place it somewhere again. Implementing it was actually quite easy. Playing around with this is again a lot of fun, but we have to address a very important question here. How strong is Steve? I mean, these stacks of diamond must be very heavy, at least as heavy as my love and appreciation for all my subscribers. Wink wink. So let's do an approximation and just give Steve the power to unearth trees. At this point, I'm already seeing the comments complaining about the blocks not having gravity, so hear me out. Number one, I had a lot more fun playing around with the floating blocks. And number two, I was just too lazy to add the existing gravity script. Okay, we are coming close to the end of the video. But I forgot one very important thing from Minecraft. Exactly. It's a T-Rex. I'm a creeper. I just imported an already existing model and used
Unity as part of the system
to get a nice explosion effect. Yeah, so that's my finished game. I actually really enjoy like just walking around, picking up the objects, and well, doing the same stuff as in Minecraft. I mean, can you do this in Minecraft? I don't think so. Then get a tree, add some shade. Oh, yeah, it's buggy. You go there. Okay. Yes. And yeah, there's like not a whole lot of things, but oh no, Flo, don't flay. Wait, go here. Okay. Get your friend. Yeah, Mr. Rose. You. Yeah, he's nice. Go to him. And Flowey. Yeah, you go to. Yeah, let's have a party. That's currently forbidden. And Rosie, you come with me because I need some friends. Hello! No, I think this is the end. I think you have to come. Don't forget to subscribe. See ya.